Hey guys, Transmech534 here. Come to my next Transformers review. And as you can see...
I don't know if it's going to
work. Fine, go ahead, introduce yourself.
Hey guys, I'm Swipe, and I'm going to be hanging around helping review some of the figures.
Well, as Swipe said, get out of the shot.
Okay, I'm going.
Get out of the shot.
Okay, jeez, no chance. I'm small.
Anyway, like I said, welcome to the next Transformers review. And as you can see, here we have...
Sentinal Prime!
So, let's get to it. Hey guys, Transmech534 here, coming to my Swipe. What are you doing up there?
I'm just sitting here.
Well, get down.
I can't. I'm scared.
Fine, I'll lift you. Stay out of the shot from now on, okay?
Yeah, okay.
Good. So, anyway, now that Swipe's out of the way, let me just fix the camera here. Yeah, as you can see, here we have Sentinal Prime. As you probably don't see, I'm in a new recording space. I'm just testing it out to see if it's any better than the old one. If it is, I'll be able to get my reviews out more often. So hopefully it is. Anyway, Sentinal Prime. This review is going to be maybe split into two parts. Not sure. Let's just see how time goes. Anyway, you may notice got a... backfire up here on his shoulder, or maybe not. No, you do. He's plugged into the one mech tech port that activates different noises, and there's a grey button here, and when you push it, you get firing sounds and lights. When you remove backfire, you get a transformation sound, and when you push the button now, we get siren sounds. So I'm going to stand him back up. A lot of people seem to be having trouble posing this guy, just because he's back heavy. He's kind of back heavy, but I don't mind. As you see, his shield fell off. this is nice, it's his mech tech weapon. What you do is you put your finger in here and hold here and push. And, this should pop out. Nice. Another thing, when you're putting it back, and put this down first, then close these, otherwise this will keep springing up. So, yeah. He does have another weapon, which I currently have sheathed. It's here on his back. You see it in there, that's his sword. Just untab it, and make it fall. But I'll bring it out, and it's a dual-sided sword. And now the background's kind of moved out of my way. There we go, that looks better. It's a dual-sided sword, it stores folded in half. Flip it out, nice. It'll fit in his hand, obviously. Get that out of the way. Considering this is a UK version, he's only going to say his name. And if you press this chest piece here, this gold piece, you get... And you can see the lights there. For poseability, we'll start at the bottom and work up. His feet are on all kinds of hinges. There's no ball joints in there, but there's so many hinges, there might as well be two ball joints there. Knees, you got swivel 360. You got bend... just below 90 degrees, and moving up here to the waist, you get out and forward back. Here on the shoulder, you get a 360 shoulder rotation. you'll notice that this is attached to the shoulder. Out here, 360 here, 90 there, and 360 on the wrist, but mine's a little stiff, so I'm not going to bother. Same on the other side, and of course, his head turns that far. So, yeah, robot mode's pretty good. I'm going to pause here and transform him off camera, because this guy's hella hard to transform. And I'll see you all back here in a moment. So here we are in vehicle mode, and... You're probably going to have to get used to that. Anyway, here we are in vehicle mode, and as you can see, we have the Rosenbauer 6x6 Panther fire truck. Now these things are usually seen around airports and places like that. places where there's really, really, really huge problems. I believe there was a couple of these at 9/11. Rest in peace, whoever suffered from that. Yeah, it's pretty big. He's smaller than other leader class figures, but you can definitely feel the heft in him. You can definitely tell he's a leader class figure. A lot of people say he's reminiscent of animated Ultra Magnus, and yeah, definitely, that is a very good call. You got this hose, which moves 360 spinning hinge here. Hinge here, which goes, and like, you get what different poses with it. You can have it going down, coming forward. Personally, I prefer it back, like so. You got a little suppression hose here. Just flips up. I prefer to keep that down. Yeah, and there is nice weapon storage for in vehicle mode. Shield stores under the fire truck, giving it a nice solid view. Just take that off. If you look very carefully, you can just see the sword stored up in here. Right there, that's the sword. I'm gonna remove the sword. Yeah, to do that, you have to pull this grey piece up. And here's the sword up under here. What is? And I'm just gonna put this back down. Now, on the back of the box, it states as vehicle mode as being this. As being this, but it doesn't show a picture of this. It shows a picture of something else, which is his stealth force mode. So far, all the leader class figures have had a stealth force mode. For Dark of the Moon, anyway. So, to start it off, fold these down, take the shield here, magtech port, magtech port, there and there, and plug it in. Push down the two sides, and you get flashing lights and transformation sound. Next, you take the sword here, and there's two slots here, two tabs here. Tabs go to slots. And now you want to push the same button that you did to make the shield transform in robot mode. When you do this time, you get firing sounds and the shield displays open. And you bring this round. But we're not done yet. You want to open these back panels here. And I'm just going to do it on one side, but flip out these little booster rockets. So yeah, you got a really, really fast bladed fire truck. You know, for if you want to fly down the highway and murder people, which, spoiler, he doesn't use this mode. Yeah, so thanks for watching. I am TransMech534.
And I'm Swift.
See y'all later.